This beautiful girl showed me a few of her really nifty defense mechanisms. You'll be amazed with her techniques. Another week, another outdoors adventure, and you know what? Black widows get a bad rap, because they're neither as deadly nor as aggressive as popular culture probably has you believe in. But I suppose I have an ethical obligation to put a disclaimer on this video, so please bear with me. The neurotoxic venom injected from a black widow bite can be lethal to humans. Although death is very unlikely to result from a black widow bite, other symptoms may result, ranging from mild to severe. Basically, you'll probably have a bad day if you experience envenomation. Sad face emoticon. COA is not advising anyone without proper skill to handle black widows without protective gear. This week, we are learning about the black widow defense mechanisms.
So I'm actually out here looking for copperheads, but I found this northern black widow, and you can tell by that broken hourglass out here in Virginia. We get the southern black widow as well where I'm at, but the hourglass on the southern black widow is not broken. In Colorado, where I grew up, used to catch the western black widow all the time. It's definitely not a species you want to get bit by, but I accidentally bumped the log when I was filming this girl, and she flew off, and she's going through a little phase where she's feigning death right now, and we call that, feigning death means faking death. It's a defense mechanism. It's also called thanatosis. It's really curious.
Come on, girl. You can go. You can go. Yeah, you can go. Come on.
And feigning death works because many predators are unable to or unwilling to eat something that is possibly disease-ridden.
No te comiere. No te comiere, bonita.
No te comiere. Come on. Go about your day. Come on. There you go.
So I've just set her on this log and want her to walk off to prove to you that she didn't get injured, but she is stubborn and sticking with this act. Quite the act.
And of course, this lovely girl has a powerful neurotoxic venom that she is capable of injecting for defense, but it's primarily used for her prey. Behind her pedipalps, she is hiding her chelicerae, or mouth parts that have fangs on the end. These are what she uses to inject her venom. Male black widows also have the potent venom, but their chelicerae are just too small to envenomate humans. Black widows produce venom that's a cocktail of ingredients, sort of like the venom injected into me when I let insects with the most potent insect venom in the world sting me, those harvester ants. The main protein toxins of black widow venom are known as latrotoxins that can each specialize on certain animal groups, like vertebrates or insects or crustaceans. Alpha latrotoxin is the vertebrate-specific component of her venom that is ineffectual against insects or crustaceans, but causes us humans some nasty symptoms. Latrodectism is the illness resulting from envenomation from latrotoxins and usually involves pain, muscle stiffness, vomiting, and perspiration. But widows are actually fairly timid and would rather have nothing to do with you. They rarely bite, and when they do, it's hardly ever lethal. Likely less than 1% of bites result in death. Though it is still suggested that if you are bit by a black widow, you seek professional medical assistance for evaluation, treatment, and possibly the antivenom. Another defense this girl uses is the colors she represents. The red patterns on her abdomen are a clear visual signal saying, "Hey, I'm dangerous." This is called aposematic coloration, and it is instinctually ingrained in many creatures to avoid other creatures with patterns and colors like this.
Is this your way of shooing me? Pushing silk at me? Oh, I got your silk.
Now that she has given up on playing dead, she is doing a little dance for me. She has spread her legs and is raising her abdomen up and down, showing her aposematic colors while also lifting her most posterior legs in the air. This is sort of like the defense posturing of a snake getting ready to strike.
Is this your defense?
She is showing with her body that she will not go down without a fight. which may deter a potential predator from taking that final risk. From her spinnerets, those organs on the end of her abdomen that produce silk, she is now grabbing silk and creating a little net weapon to try and snag and slow down her threat. Granted, this last-ditch effort doesn't do much on me, but it may save her life if a smaller predator came at her. It is also possible that she could be spreading pheromones or chemical signals on this silk that are anti-predator in nature, as she uses pheromones on her silk for communication, such as with a mate. But that's just an unsubstantiated hypothesis of mine. I thank this little lady for being a wonderful participant and showing her defense mechanisms, but it is now time to let her be so that she can have a successful future. I put her back as I found her and wished her good luck for her future days. If you respect nature and you enjoy the outdoors, then you are welcome to join the team by subscribing for free. We would love to have you. Also, you can get gifts now for being a patron of Cohen Nature, and that's on top of the bloopers and behind the scenes and personal updates from yours truly. Patreon is a crowdfunding site that supports creators like me so that I can keep making these educational and entertaining videos for you and everyone out there. So I thank my patrons who toss me a few bucks or more every month to make these free videos possible. I know times are rough right now, fiscally as well as emotionally, and so I hope you're doing well out there. Spread some knowledge, be nature heroic.